So the administrator's office, the door probably was locked at some point, but is open now. The lock is unpowered, so you can just pull the door aside. Inside, there's a big like view screen on the back wall. Obviously, he's dead now. He's got a big like oak desk. Probably really expensive to ship here, but very fancy. Panels like from the ceiling have fallen down and like chipped the desk though. His terminal, he's got a computer terminal here that's built into the desk. It's also obviously offline. And then the desk itself has several like locked drawers. And then there's some chairs that have been knocked over. And this room is sort of just on its own. He's got its own like side, like a bathroom or whatever, but there's no other way out of this room.
Computer terminals in the administration offices?
Yeah, it's built into the admin guy's desk, the administrator's desk.
But no power.
Yeah, no power anywhere.
But we could potentially, I mean, yeah, the admin guy, he's probably not going to have interesting research. Let's go to the labs.
I thought you wanted to go to the fucking landing pad. What the
Yeah, but labs are just back there, right? Like they're in the offices and then off the other side.
Yeah, go through the office.
The heat's doing something to Victor. He's a little cuckoo today.
Victor, okay.
I thought it'd be cooler in here, you guys. I don't know. I'm sorry. It's really hard.
I check the desk. Like I walk over and like slide my finger and see if it's dusty or anything like that. And then underneath, I'm like, well, what about right here? And I like go to see if there's a secret compartment. Just like hit something, wait something to happen. Does anything occur?
Yeah, there's actually totally like a switch under the desk.
Yeah, I flip the switch.
Yeah, when you pull it, one of the drawers pops open. Inside the drawer, there is an empty like pistol case. So like like for a revolver or something, it's open. And the gun is missing, and one of the six bullets in the case is missing.
Okay, well I take the bullets. I would put those.
Okay. Right, you have five revolver bullets.
Hey man, I only had 10 total. I guess the laser pistol doesn't use actual ammo, but yeah.
No,
probably
no.
Not.
You could throw the bullets at someone really hard.
Though. Yeah.
I'll put this and put a grenade and throw them at the same time. It'll be great.
Could chew on them in moments of boredom.
Yeah. But yeah, so this gun is missing and one bullet is gone. The room otherwise is pretty empty. There are other drawers that you can like pull or jimmy open if you want to. They're only locked with like a basic like locking.
As they investigate the room, I step out of the office and I'm just listening for any movement or anything like that outside.
Can you make a perception check for me?
Sure.
Just get 7 or better and I'll tell you some thing.
Hello. Whoops.
What? D26.
That's a D26.
Well, it's still a good roll on a D26, actually.
It is. Okay. Very good roll.
So you,
notice these rolls, by the way?
Yeah, we're all rolling pretty high.
So you go out into the hall, and your suit kind of helps you like tune out the arguing of your fellows 2 rooms away, and you pick up a sound down towards the armory.
Okay.
Yeah, like you hear a person's voice. It's really quiet. It might be someone talking to themselves or something, but it's like just enough that you can hear it above the ambient kind of like howling of the wind outside.
Does it sound like creepy weeping?
No, it doesn't.
Okay.
Also, you're not there.
Well,
so
I'm going to over the comms say I'm investigating a sound in the armory, and then I'm going to head towards the armory.
I go with him.
I'm still fucking with the desk. I'm really.
Yeah, you know, Higgs and his magical button finding abilities. You know, I'm meant for other things.
Okay.
Deal with them first, then you come back to me.
Oh no, I was gonna talk to you, but you had a question?
Oh, I was gonna say I take the metal plate out from under my chest and I'm using it to try to jimmy the drawer so.
Nice. Okay. Yeah, so you can pop the drawers pretty easily. One of the drawers has a mostly full bottle of bourbon in it.
Yep, take it. Bourbon.
A couple of glasses. Another drawer is full of just miscellaneous like office supplies more bourbon, a tablet and like a stylus. And there is a recording, like a disc or whatever that you would put into a terminal to be able to view some data.
Yeah, I flick that over to Piani and say, this is your territory. I don't, you might want to see if that's any good.
Okay.
And then I take a swig of the bourbon. Is it high quality?
Yeah. Oh, it's really, yeah.
It's like a compad that I just got?
It's like a USB stick, basically.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so put just write down you have the administrator's
okay.
like, stick, administrator's disk.
All right, so I'm going to put bourbon plus three. Is that?
Hells yeah, put plus three bourbon on there. It's okay. Delicious. There's like about three quarters of a bottle left.
Gotcha. Okay. I offered a Peony. I just kind of like motion it towards you.
Weed, I don't know if maybe your character would notice this, like looking at the disc, but it's got it doesn't have the Anaximander University like logo on it. It's a Richardson Scientific like stick. It's like branded with their corporate like seal.
Which is what, like their competitors?
No, they're just like an independent research organization. You guys worked for them in the very first mission. You brought something back from Antony for them.
I mean, that's just a corporation, right? Instead of the university. That's and right. We thought we were running this for the university, and maybe there's actually a corporation working in on this.
Who knows?
Yeah. Right. I take note of that.
Okay. All right. So, security.
I mean, I suppose there's nothing. I still don't have communication with Pi, so there's nothing I can really do with this except pocket it.
Yeah. Okay. Pocket it for now. Once you get back to the ship, or if you get the power back on, you'll
be sure. Great.
Access it on any terminal. So Kovex and Sicarian, you two run off towards the armory. And it looks like, you know, after you like turn a corner on your way to the armory and you can see like obvious signs of a fight here. There's lots of like bullet holes in the walls, burn marks, more like dark smears on the floor and the walls. You can see that it looks like there are like drag marks where like there'll be a large sort of like dried liquid smear and then a long drag mark away. And then the drag mark just kind of gets pulled away like something got picked up off the floor. There's a barricade made out of like office furniture right before you get to the armory. And now you can both hear there's like a voice on the other side of the armory door, which is shut.
I look at Kovax, and there's just a like pregnant pause. I just kind of look at him.
Mm.
I don't make any face, and then I look away, and then I go to open the door.
So Kovax, Kovax, for a moment, you see like, yeah, Sicarian turns his head towards you, and you catch your own reflection in his like view, like visor of his helmet, and you look a little shaken, you like sweaty forehead, and like.
Yep. Yeah. Kovax just sort of nods at Sicarian, and he goes and he stands over like next to the door, pistol in two hands. He's like ready to cover the door as soon as it opens.
Okay. Ha!
He actually practices a couple times.
Such confidence.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So Sicarian, you wanna crack the door?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what he does.
So the lock, again, the electronic lock is disabled, so you can pull it open. And when you do, both of you can hear now at almost full volume the sound that was coming from the armory. It's a woman singing. She's singing in Mandarin, which I don't think either of you understand. And you can hear like a faint, like there's like backing music to it as well.
I speak.
Yeah, but we're not there.
You're not there.
Oh, that's right.
You're drinking bourbon.
Right. Yeah, we're having bourbon. I've actually gotten a glass already? Out and just like put another glass on there and poured it in some more. Nice.
Okay. So the armory it's not a large room. Like they don't have, I'll say this, like Sicarian, they have more guns than you would expect, or more room for guns. There's actually no guns in this room. They have more room for guns than you would expect from like a research station, even one at the far end of the sector. There's, you know, several, like a half dozen racks meant for holding like assault rifles and combat armor. All of which are empty. There's maybe like a helmet or two or some magazines that were dropped on the floor. And the back kind of quarter of the armory, one of the racks is like just melted from like an incendiary grenade. The walls are all burned and the rack kind of just like triangles off into a pile of slag in the back corner.
You said there's music playing, right? That's what we heard?
Yeah, you can hear music playing from somewhere, but the room is big enough and has enough like racks you'd have to kind of walk up and down.
Well, that's what I'm doing then. I'm walking towards the sound and just kind of going in.
Okay, all right.
I cover his back.
Okay, so you come around a corner, around one of the racks. The light from your shoulder casting these like harsh shadows of the kind of hex grid that makes up the rack across. first a pool of like dried blood on the floor, and then your vision tracks up over the smear of blood, and you see feet and then legs and then a person's torso. You see the sort of like gunmetal like glint of a pistol lying on the ground. And then you get to about here and there's not much left. There's like a bottom jaw and then just head a off. Mess on the wall. In the person's other hand, there's a like a hollow terminal, obviously running off a battery, that the battery is starting to die. There's a flickering light of a, there's a woman singing, like a Chinese like woman dressed in like a fairly like, she's not wearing like a traditional outfit, but it's an obviously like a Chinese influenced like pop singer kind of outfit. She's very flashy, but it's just a little tiny hologram, and she's just singing the same loop over and over. And this guy is just like lying.
Okay. What's over the comm, I say we have a casualty in the armory, dead before arrival, or dead upon arrival. Gunshot wound to the head. It would seem beyond alert.
And is this good, buddy? I got that 10-4 on the dead body. Click.
Do you tell this to everybody just in the facility, or are you beaming us back to the ship too?
I would say it's the four-way comm, just between the four of us.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah, keep it professional.
After that goes off, I'm sitting on the desk with my legs up with a glass of bourbon, and I'm just like, Piana, you ever think about how big space is? And I'm just like swirling the bourbon in the glass.
So this is actually really awesome. Like if you imagine this is a, like a movie or a TV show. So you put your feet up on the desk, and the camera kind of pans along your boots, your dirty boots, to a picture that's like sitting on the desk, and it's the same guy, and he's like got his arm around the doctor that's like on your ship, and they're on Anaximander. And they're like the doctor's got his like graduation like gown on and stuff, and then it snaps back to Sicarian and Kovacs, and you guys are in the room, and you can see this guy wearing the like, he's wearing like a nice suit and stuff. Obviously, his like tie is on.
Is the caliber of the pistol strong enough to remove his head that way?
No, it definitely would have killed him, but it wouldn't have. Yeah, like
so. With my training, I would look at this and know that he was. It was not a suicide. He was killed by something else.
Well, make a perception test, and I'll tell you some more about that.
Can I add tactics to it because of my training?
Yeah, totally.
All right, so it's 2d6 plus 1 then.
Sure.
9.
Nice. Okay. Yeah, I mean, you see evidence on the wall behind him of you know, the splatter of like a low caliber pistol. Like he's just holding like a police revolver, like a 38 or whatever. But it looks like his head was removed from the upper jaw up after that. There's like actually score marks in the wall behind him that look like they're from like a bladed implement, like someone like stuck a pitchfork at the wall and like scraped it up and pulled his head off. Mm. Obviously it wasn't literally a pitchfork, but that's the gist of it.
I would like to science those and see if they could be perhaps made by some kind of chitinous natural weapons on,
I like
for
how
example,
Victor uses science as a verb. I'm going to science that shit.
Yeah, I'm
basically
science.
What you're doing is you're going to use that roll to land on when you jump to these conclusions.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
It's a mat that you
can science mat. Conclusion.
No, I look at the wall and I science as hard
as
I can.
I mean,
but
you lean in to take a look, and you catch a like a whiff of that intense chlorine smell, but also something like sulfurous, and then also probably human waste from the body voiding itself out in the heat. And yeah, you start to gag, and you have to stumble away. So, Sicarian.
Again, he sees this suit kind of look at him.
Dumbass.
We should get back with the others and continue to investigate as a team.
Yeah, that sounds good. Let's get out of here. There's some kind of pitchfork or something that took this guy's head off. Okay, I'll catch up. There's something I gotta do.
All right. So, Sicarian,
I stay with him. Yeah, no,
you stay with him.
An idiot. Yeah.
I will wait. Thank you.
Okay, we're ready to go. We're ready.
Do you guys, Piani and Higgs, do you guys want to do anything in the offices or the admin office now?
I have a polite
Higgs,
conversation.
Okay. You wax philosophical. Yeah. I think you guys get an audio message, because it's been a few minutes. You get a message like from the ship, and Dr. Said is like, Captain Higgins, what's happening in there? What's going on?
Well, I've got a nice bottle of bourbon, and I'm sitting here in the administrator's office. What's going on with you?
He says, "Oh, thank Allah, everything is all right. Should I come and join you? Will you be coming back to retrieve me? What happened?"
Well, and I look at Piani and just kind of like, what you just do, like the, you're like, guess what, or what, I don't know, or what he's, how are you reacting to this?
Give it to him straight.
Sorry, yeah.
I'm just like, well, I didn't say that I was talking to the administrator. We don't know where he's at. There's also no power in this area.
Adam, can I like communicate just to the four of us, but accidentally have it sent over?
You can accidentally do whatever you want, man.
Yeah, I'd like to like flip on in a haste and be like, Higgs, look, we got to get to the labs. I think this is some kind of like weapons research facility. Everything's blown up. There's a guy who's dead down here. We really have to figure out what the hell's going on, Higgs.
And then you just like click off.
Yeah, I just say meet us at the intersection. We got to go to the labs, man.
All right, doctor, I got to go meet him at the labs. We'll be back to the ship soon. Have a good one. And I just click off.
Fantastic. That wasn't okay. Totally obvious. All right. So, he's probably panicking on the ship now. But that's fine. He's panicking with your AI friend.
I'm sure probably will keep under control. Contemplating lying. And yeah.
No.
No bad intent. Hi.
So sometimes you have to lie for a good reason.
Right.
All right. So you guys are all going to meet back up in the offices?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you're back in the office. Kovacs and Sakirian come back. And yeah, Kovacs looks a little shaken. Sakirian looks like a wall of plasteel toughness.
Mm-hmm.
Higgs and Piani have their... Higgs has the bottle of bourbon, which is now like, you know, half full.
Yep. I just pointed that aside. Do you mind?
I just kind of like look at him and tell my head, I'm like, yeah, I do. You smell kind of funny. And also, no, you can't have this bourbon. This is my bourbon. I found it and it's mine.
You're an asshole, Higgs. Let's go.
I have been called ruder things. Let's take a move on.
All right, Sakirian, where's Combat Team Swansong headed to next?
The labs, I suppose. It's like one of the more major areas we haven't checked, right?
Okay. All right. So you get to the labs, and you know, you walk across the offices. The lab doors are actually they're like metal security doors, and they don't have windows in them. You can't see into the labs from here, and they're shut. Then they seem to have like a manual lock on the other side.
Like is it the sort of thing we could like bash through?
They're like metal, closed metal doors. Okay. If you got something like wedged in there or like tried to pull it apart, you might be able to, but it's going to be tough.
There's no other way to go.
Do I just blow it open?
Besides physical?
You can just try and blast. Yeah, I mean, aside from that, if you restore power to the whole facility, then you can use like the computers to try and get access to different areas or whatever.
Yeah, I just kind of like look at them like, Mr. S, I believe you have the key to this door.
Sure.
Okay.
What do I roll to shoot?
You don't have to roll to hit it. you just go ahead and shoot it, man. Like you got a plasma cannon, it takes a few shots, but yeah, roll a d4. Let's see how many shots it takes to blow the door in. Okay, one shot. Just fucking blast that.
Sakirian, God.
All right.
Boom.
So
we don't need the rest of us. We just need you to go through here and shoot everything until it, you know. I shoot the guy until he tells me what we're doing. I shoot the door until it opens.
Let that be a lesson to everyone out there. If it doesn't work, just shoot it, and it should be fine.
Guns solve everything, ladies and gentlemen. It's proven on the American way.
Do you hear that, Pi?
Oh, yeah.
So I step through the smoldering wreckage, by the way.
Yeah, you blast a hole in the door. You kind of, like, climb through the wreckage. So inside, there is, as promised, a lab. It looks like it was a sterile environment at one point, but there is... fire retardant foam everywhere, which is like hardened on a lot of the surfaces. So this weird sort of bluish foam that's like sealed a lot of the furniture in these like sort of piles of frozen foam. There are rows of tables, and I assume, is everybody going to follow Sakirian in, or are you You want to say it's up? Yeah. Right. So when you get in there, like Victor, you see like this is not the kind of lab you would expect in like a xenosociology research station. There's several like metal like morgue tables. They're all empty right now. There is a number of like glass specimen cases against the wall. They're all empty too. Many of them are broken. You know, so there's broken glass all over the floor. There's a big like drainage port in the middle of the floor, and the floor is kind of like swept down into it so that if fluid spill, it could drain in. You notice at the very back of the lab, there's another door. It's unmarked, sealed, and all it says above it is access restricted. And it's got like a palm like pad next to it.
I put my hand on it.
Okay, it doesn't do anything because it doesn't have any power. It feels like a glass panel though.
Mr. S.
There's no computers or like, you know,
Mr.
data
Kovacs.
Slates or anything in here.
What is this?
Yeah,
foam?
I mean there are a few panels, but they're like, I mean they're mostly foamed over.
Okay. Could I use a type A battery to power the access to the door in order for like Piani to try to like hack through it or something like that?
Well, I mean you'd have to find a way for Piani to communicate with the panels.
Right.
I think we just got to fucking turn the power on.
That's a trap. It's what the DM wants.
Mr. Kovacs, what is this foam that covers everything?
I identify the foam. It's just normal flame
it's
retardant.
It's a non-conductive flame retardant foam. The idea is that if there's a fire, they spray it all over everything. Yeah, exactly. They spray it all over everything. It hardens, suffocates the fire, and then there's another system that you can use to dissolve the foam into just harmless... stuff.
I'll investigate the sealed door. Does it look like a door I can blast open as well?
It's hard to tell. If you knock on it, it seems pretty thick. This one, you might not be able to just blast through it.
My question is, and I'm saying this as Victor, is what? I mean, we're in like a steel room, right?
Yep.
What's in here?
Sterile environment.
Right, what in here caused the fire retardant system to go off? That's strange, guys. There's definitely more going on here than we are seeing. Obviously, this is not a simple xenosociology research station. I could tell you.
I hand him a glass of bourbon and just be like, "Can you drink this and shut up?"
You do seem nervous.
Let's go turn on the power.
Where would be? I agree. We should probably turn on the power. Where should we go to do that?
Piani! No. Pi! Put Saeed on.
Let's try to make this snappy, guys. I don't want to... I want to get this over with and get out of here, get our pay.
Saeed, where's the power?
So he reluctantly returns to one of the comms panels in the Swan Song. And he says, what do you mean, where is the power?
Do you know where we can fucking turn it on?
This is Sicarian. The power is off in the station. Where should we go to get it on?
There should be emergency power. It kicks in the case of main generator failure.
What happens if that doesn't kick in?
Okay, if we had emergency power, none of us would be calling you right now. Again, where's the power?
I believe... And it's been some time since I've seen the blueprints for the facility. I believe there's a generator control station. It should be located near the facility, but not a part of it. South of the docking bay, I believe. Outside, it's an independent facility.
Well, maybe one of those small huts we saw when we were flying in.
Yes.
Okay.
Most likely.
Let's go to the docking
bay. Sicarian, you wanna go take a look at that with me?
Yeah, let's double time it.
All right, we hoof it. Hut.
Okay, so you guys want to like go back out the way you came and then find your way to that.
I recommend we all travel as a unit. We still don't know what we're facing here, so you should stay with us.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So you guys leave the building and head back out into the heat. And you can see the comms tower, obviously, through the smog. And then a little ways off, you can see the cluster of other buildings. And so you head off through the smog towards them. The wind is starting to pick up. There's like howling. Those of you with helmets on, you can hear the like larger grains of dirt and stuff pinging off of your helmet. Higgs, you and Kovacs have to like shield your eyes to continue on towards the building.
Sure.
And can actually everybody make a perception check for me?
Yes.
Just a six this time.
That's based D26. Off of 2d6, right?
Yeah, it's 2d6 plus your wisdom.
The general rule of Sicarian is it gets plus nothing except for dexterity.
did you want to roll? Do you want to roll 2d6 one. Instead of
d26?
12.
Damn.
Okay. Jeff, you wanna make your roll?
Well, I rolled a 2d6, didn't I?
Yeah, yeah, I rolled a d26.
Again?
I mean, that's a roll you could have gotten.
There you go.
Yeah, all right, that's better.
So Piani, you hear it first. Above the wind and the like rocks getting kind of like rattled around at your feet from the wind, you hear a faint like hum. In fact, you kind of like feel it first, like in your sternum, this like low bass like humming sound. Yeah, you notice it. You're about, you know, a third of the way towards the main building.
And I mean, it's like a sound or a feeling?
Sound is vibration. So you feel it first, and then when you notice it, you're like, "What the fuck is that?" And then you
I'm
can
sorry.
Kind of hear.
Let me. Do I feel it? You said I sort
does
of.
Does he feel it coming in the air tonight?
Or do I like feel it on my like feet building up? Like
so, it's something. Yeah, it's something in the air. The ground isn't shaking. You can feel like it's like standing next to a really loud like bass speaker, but you don't hear the sound yet. You just hear this like feel this like. Vibrating in your bones, and then you start to hear this dull like sound.
Can you feel that?
Do I hear it yet?
Yeah, Victor and Higgs, when Piani mentions it, you both kind of like
I feel absolutely nothing. What are you referring to?
Sicarian, I think there is a large cluster of insectoid wings all beating in time nearby, perhaps in the hive that's lurking beneath this station. We should book it to the generator to turn the power on.
Are the aliens here insect-like?
Yes, the Vod are insectoids, ape-level intelligence species.
Are they hostile?
They, Saeed said they weren't, but that guy's a dick.
If you hit them with a searing ball of heat, will it die?
I believe yes.
Okay, we continue.
I think we're good, then. I mean, he's got all the balls of heat that we need, don't you?
We've got way more than those...
Let's turn on the generator, get back in, complete the mission, make our payday, and get out of here.
Yep.
I fucking hate it when Victor's right.
So do you guys want to just continue at like a normal patrol pace, or do you want to book it?
I'm not running. I'm not going to run.
It's normal patrol.
Yeah.
Normal patrol. All right. Maybe, you know, heightened alert. Victor's holding his gun.
Yes. Yeah, I mean, you can't see more than a couple of meters ahead of you anyway because of the smog, but you're moving towards the dark square shape that you think is the generator station. So as you approach, the humming continues. It gets louder. And then another sort of separate humming picks up from ahead of you. It's vibrating on like a slightly different frequency. It's a little higher and comes in pulses.
That's the queen.
And you approach the building, but out of the smog, you can see reinforced like electrical fence. That just kind of emerges out of the smog. There's a gate in front of you, but it is shut. And you can definitely like hear that like hum, kind of humming and crackling in the air. You can see in the distance on the other side of the fence, the building itself. And something is on, there's like movement on top of the building. You catch like the darkness kind of like shift slightly as you approach.
There's no power anywhere else, but like, can I tell now that the humming and crackling is coming from the power on the fence?
The fence is definitely on, yeah. I mean, as the, like, debris from the wind is, like, hitting it, it's, like, sparking and stuff.
Dang it, our plans are totally fucked. Sicarian, would you care to blast a hole in this fence for us?
Yes.
Okay. So you want to unleash another shot at the gate of the fence?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Okay. The fence was not designed to keep out plasma weapons, so yeah, you just like melt the door, the gate, and it starts to collapse. But the firing of the pulse rifle, it alerts whatever is like moving, and you hear that the deeper bass kind of like kick up 3 or 4 octaves, and there's a dark shape that like lifts off up of the top of the building and starts moving towards you. And when I say large, like it's like car sized.
We should get inside that building immediately.
Yeah, starts coming towards you. So this is probably a good place to take our second break, and we'll figure out if you can get away from the dark humming blur at the beginning of the next bit.
Cool. Sounds good. Okay. We'll do just that. So we'll see you guys in about 3 minutes. Thanks, everyone, for watching. Be right back.